Morning guys, let us look into today parse table construction. Our topic of discussion is parse table construction. Now, very first step, what you supposed to consider for the parse table construction is you need to harvest all the terminal symbols from the given grammar. What are all the terminal symbols available? If you look at the grammar, plus is one of the terminal symbol. 1 minute. I'll take one of the marker and I can proceed with annotation tool. Plus is one of the terminal symbol. Epsilon is another terminal symbol. If you look at this, plus is one terminal symbol. Epsilon is not at all considered as terminal symbol because we cannot represent epsilon in our machine, but it is terminal symbol. This plus is terminal symbol. Star is terminal symbol and epsilon, one more, I will change the color. Yeah, the star is terminal symbol. Then again, open bracket is terminal symbol. If you look at this, close bracket is terminal symbol. ID is terminal symbol. Could you able to understand what I'm trying to tell? All the terminal symbols. That means another way I can say, the symbol which are all not available on the left hand side, all are treated as terminal symbol. The symbol which are all available on the left hand side, LHS, before this production symbol, all are termed as non-terminal, simple. If you are not able to understand in that aspect also, you can understand in this way. Symbol which are all available on the left hand side are all termed as non-terminal. First, try to understand this. Fantastic. Now what are you supposed to do? You need to use this symbols, all the non-terminals on the row entity. You need to construct a row using non-terminals. Then find out all the terminal symbols excluding this epsilon. Then constitute all the columns. You need to create a column with all the terminal symbols. Now, one special symbol you need to consider, that is the symbol S. This special symbol S you need to consider, this special symbol dollar you need to consider. This is additional. Dollar symbol never ever will be given in your grammar. You need to artificially include. Only three steps. I'll repeat again. You may need to consider all the, you may need to consider all the, you may need to consider all the non-terminals, terminals. All the non-terminals are going to form your rows in the parse table. All the terminals are going to form the columns in the parse table. In addition to terminals, you need to consider dollar a special symbol. That's all you need to understand. Nothing more you are going to understand. Is it clear now? Now, look at the table. All the non-terminals constitute a row. All the terminals constitute a column. One new symbol dollar. This is a very, very preliminary steps. See, here itself I have written non-terminals. Here itself it is said as input symbols. Now, let us see what we supposed to do. Now, look at E. Then you need to consider this row. Whenever I am saying E, you need to focus on the table row E. Fine. Look at the symbol. First symbol. Don't look at follow. First you need to look at. Consider open bracket. Now there is a column with open bracket. Write this production. This production. Next. Consider the second symbol ID. Second symbol ID. Look at the row ID. This is fixed. E row is fixed. Then for that first symbol, you need to write the production. This is step number one. Next, step number two. Let us move on to step number two. I'll minimize it so that I can cover everything in a single page. Now look at next process of our next our process is to consider E dash. This E dash. We need to fix this E dash in the row wise. look at the first symbol. There is a first symbol plus. When it is a symbol plus, I need to fix the column plus. Then corresponding row and column, I need to fill up this grammar. Which grammar? This grammar. Plus, wherever is available, that grammar you need to look at. The grammar which has the plus, that production we need to look at. Yes, I have written. Next, look at the symbol epsilon. Pay your attention carefully. Look at the symbol epsilon. Now the problem comes. The strategy changes. Whenever epsilon comes, immediately we need to look at the follow. Look at the follow has dollar. Then I need to fix my mind in the dollar column. The moment I fix my mind in the dollar column, I need to write the production E epsilon production. So that I am writing E epsilon production. Next, I need to look at the remaining follow symbol. The remaining follow symbol has only one open bracket. I need to fix my mind with this, close bracket. Then I need to write the production E dash epsilon. This is the second strategy. Even if you don't understand, please wait for some more time. The same kind of thing going to be repeated. T dash F. By that time, you may be able to understand. Nothing to worry. So now, let us move ahead with the production T. I am looking at the production T. I need to fix my mind with the T symbol in the row. I need to look at the first. First of T has open bracket. The moment it says open bracket, I need to fix my mind with the open bracket column. Look at the production. TFT dash. This production I need to write here. TFT dash. Next, I need to look at the symbol ID. This is my second symbol. I need to fix my mind in the column E. Look at the corresponding entry. I need to write this production T produces FT dash. That's it. Now I am going to the next step. I need to look at the production T dash. Because of this, I need to focus on the row T dash. Next, I need to look at the symbol, first symbol of T dash. Star is the first symbol of T dash. I need to focus on the column star. When I focus on the column star, the production which has T star F T dash, I need to consider. I need to fill the entry T produces star F T dash. Next, now the another scenario comes. Look at my next first symbol, epsilon. The moment I see the epsilon, I don't have column. I need to make a jump or I need to visit or look at my follow. My follow says plus symbol. I need to focus on plus. The moment I focus on plus, to this combination, T plus combination, I need to give this entry. The entry is T dash produces epsilon production. Next, I need to look at dollar symbol. My focus is towards the dollar symbol. The pair T dash and dollar, I need to introduce the production T dash epsilon. Next, I need to focus on the last symbol of the follow collection, that is close bracket. I am looking into this combination. I'm going to make a pair T dash close bracket. I'm going to introduce the production T dash epsilon. That's all. There are two scenario, guys. If the input symbol doesn't have epsilon, that is one category. The input symbol consists of the collection input first computation. That first computation contains epsilon. You need to immediately look into follow. Then all the follow symbols you need to fill up. You need to fill up this entries, epsilon entries you need to fill up. That you should understand. Always epsilon comes, you are going to look at follow. If there is no epsilon, no worries. You are so comfortable. Only the first symbol you will be collecting, looking at, you will be combining the pair combination, non-terminal, terminal. Then you are going to introduce that production. If epsilon comes only, another strategy. You need to look at the follow symbols. That's all. Nothing more you need to worry of. Now, let us move on to the next illustration. I am considering the production F. Then my focus should be on the symbol F. If my focus is on the symbol F, I need to look at the first. First of F is having open bracket. Immediately, I need to make a attention on the column open bracket. The pair F and open bracket, I need to introduce the production which has the open bracket. F produces open bracket E is the appropriate way to write. I need to look at the next first symbol. It is ID. Then I need to introduce the production. F produces ID because this is the combination has ID. So that I am introducing F produces ID. That's it. I give 1 minute time. Have you look at it. Then tell me. If you have doubt, let me clarify your doubt. If not, let me proceed with the further discussion. Parsing action. Predictive parse table has 4 major steps. One is first computation. We are all very much or pretty much clear. Next is follow computation. Third step is parse table design or parse table construction. In that parse table, all the row is going to be designed with non-terminals, all the columns we are going to design with terminals. In addition, we are including one special symbol that is called dollar. That's it. Then you need to look at every time first of that particular non-terminal combination. Then if the first doesn't have epsilon, it has different strategy. If the first has epsilon, it has different strategy. That's it. No more confusion. Have a look at it. You need to acknowledge me whether you are clear with the concept, you are understanding the concept or not, or where you are having the issue in order to understand that particular context. Go ahead. I give just 20 seconds or 30 seconds. You need to respond to me. Then only then I'll proceed with. Yes, fine. Anyone else could able to acknowledge? Understood. Mm-hmm. Very fine. Yeah. D4 and D7. There are only 4 guys always interactive. Then other people are, I don't know whether they are away from mobile or internet only attending the session, not the person. Fine. Thank you, my E0 and F3. Now let us move on to the next concept called parsing action. For that parsing action, we need to understand this. Let me choose a color, then I'll come back. Look at this. This is the given input. ID plus ID star ID. We need to parse using this CFG. CFG will not help us. Who is going to help us is predictive table. Predictive parsing table. Predictive parsing PPD, predictive parsing table only going to help us. This is a kind of an algorithm. Predictive parsing table only going to become algorithm. The table which we have constructed just recently is termed as LL1 parsing or LL1 parsing table. Or you can say non-recursive parsing table, or you can say predictive parsing table. Choice is yours. All are interchangeable words. So this is a given grammar. Just now we have got an algorithm that is called LL1 parser table, or we can say predictive parser table. The given input string for our parsing action is ID plus ID star ID. With that introduction, I am going to the fourth segment of the parsing action called parsing the given input string. That's all. Now let us move on to this. Look at this is the now the problem for me is how I make you to refer this grammar. You just look at the grammar, little bit pattern of this grammar is sufficient, or this table, little bit pattern of this table is sufficient. We can go ahead with the parsing table. I'll otherwise swing from front and back. See, first you need to fill the stack with dollar. first, very first stack need to be filled with dollar. That is our prime requirement. Once the stack is filled with dollar, we need to fill with the starting symbol of the grammar. In our given CFG or grammar set, E is the starting symbol. That is the content of stack. Now we are loading the input buffer. Input is given as ID plus ID star ID. Then input buffer also need to be loaded with dollar. That is the indicator where it starts, because emptiness cannot be understood by the computer or the processor. In order to identify whether we are going to start or end, these are all the indicators, ending also, starting also. Loading dollar into stack, loading dollar into input buffer helps us starting action as well as ending action, stop action. So that is why it is forced to load these two symbols. Not necessarily dollar, you can load any special symbol, but the meaning is when we reach that symbol, our task over. That is the meaning dollar. Now, very first, what we supposed to do is we need to look at the combination E dollar. See what is available into the stack. That combination we need to look at. Stack contains the symbol called E and dollar. Then what I supposed to do is I need to look at the parsing table E dollar. This E and dollar pair I need to look at. I need to look at the row E row, and I need to look at the column dollar column. Then whatever it says, I need to do the action. Let us move there, then we will come back here. Now look at E is the symbol. This is a column I need to look at. Then what is a pair? Dollar. E dollar. I need to look at this combination E. E first I need to replace. One minute. EID pair, not dollar. EID pair. EID pair, I need to look at this. E produces T dash. Let us go back there. Just remember this. This is the pair we are going to look at. What is available, just remember. Then you can understand what I am trying to tell after reaching this situation. What we are supposed to do is look at this is E. Look at this is ID. This combination only we need to look at. I literally given wrong note, E dollar note. That is not right. E and ID pair. We need to make a pair of top of the in stack. Top of the stack is E. Top of the buffer is ID. So we need to make a pair EID. Just now I said TE dash. So that I am replacing E by TE dash onto the stack. This is the step. See. What action I have taken, I am writing here. No need to revisit that. Here itself I can say. T producer, E produces TE dash. Now, the next action, what pair I should look at? Tell me. Be interactive into the chat window. Next. I said no. EID pair. Now, what is a pair I need to look at? Table. Always we are referring the table. Now, which entry, which row, which column entry I need to look at? Give me that pair. What non-terminal, what terminal I need to look at, or the combination of what stack content, what input buffer content, I need to make a pair. First time I made a pair between EID. Now what combination I need to make a pair? Respond to me, guys. This much time it won't take. Very simple. Very first time I looked at top of the stack and top of the input buffer. Those two I made a pair. No response? Not even single one. Not even a single one. Oh my God. Give some signal, yaar. Some wrong. T and capital T. Yeah, T and ID. Very good. T and ID. Now I supposed to make a pair. T and ID. What is my top of the stack I should look at? T is my top of the stack. What is my top of the input buffer? ID. symbol under consideration or scanning. Now I need to make a pair TID. I need to look into the table. TID pair has the entry TFT dash. So that what I am doing, this T symbol is replaced by FT dash. The remaining E dash retained as such, dollar is retained as such. Got the point? Now the next question starts. Now what is the combination I need to make a pair? Next combination, which combination I need to make a pair? This step TID, FID, fantastic. Now I need to make a pair between F and ID. F and ID, if I look at the table combination, the entry definitely it would be F produces ID. Look at, now this F is replaced by ID. The moment ID comes here, the cancellation or acceptance starts. Matching, perfect matching is happening. The given input by the user, scanned by the compiler, right up to what? Up to first ID, compiler recognizes the input given by the user. That is the way the parsing action is happening. You can understand little bit more about how parsing is happening. Now the moment ID and ID matches, match ID, just we need to remove, not remove, matched, then it will be considered as matched. But it will be removed both from the input and it will be removed from the stack also. So once it is removed, now what is the top of the stack? Tell me, ID and ID is removed. What is the top of the stack? Just tell me top of the stack. T dash. Let me see. Yeah, T dash, fantastic. Now what is a pair I need to do? T dash is top of the stack. What is a pair I need to look at into the parsing table? Non-terminal and terminal pair. T dash is non-terminal. Yeah, T dash and plus, exactly. Now to the table, we need to look at T dash and plus combination. If you look at T dash and plus combination, the production would be T dash epsilon. I'm just avoiding scanning to that table. Otherwise, exactly it will be, if you look at the entry T dash and plus combination, it would be T dash epsilon. That is with that question I'm not asking you. Then what is the meaning? I need to replace T dash by epsilon. Then ultimately I'm nullifying this non-terminal. I'm erasing, removing or kicking out. That's it. Now, what is the combination I need to look at? At this stage, what combination I should look at? D4, you are not able to understand. Okay, let me start from the beginning. Wait a minute. Pay your attention. See, very first, what we are trying to do is, we need to load dollar symbol onto the stack, empty stack. We need to take empty input buffer. We need to load dollar symbol. This is the very first step. Second step, in our given CFG grammar, start symbol we need to identify. That start symbol, we need to push it onto the stack immediately. The start symbol given to our grammar is capital E. We are pushing it onto the stack. Then the given input string, that is this input is given by the user, programmer. ID plus ID star ID, identifier A plus B into C. You will be giving, no? You will be writing expression, no? That expression is to be loaded into input buffer. This is very first stage or initialization or initial configuration process. The moment you are thorough on this, next step, very immediate step, what you supposed to do is, you need to concentrate on top of the stack, capital E. You need to concentrate on the very first symbol of the input string. Left to right scanning, this is called left to right associativity. The way in which you scan the input is called associativity. Given the user expression, scanned in the direction left to right. So when I scan the direction left to right, my first combination is ID. In my mind, I need to make a pair capital E comma ID. That's all. Now I am making a pair. Next, I will tell you this pair you need to remember in your brain, capital E and ID. Now I will take you to the table. Now you can understand. Look at the table. Now you can understand better. E and id. I need to look at these two pair. When I look at these two pair, what is the entry available? E produces te dash. What this signifies is, on the stack, E need to be replaced by te dash. This is what I am doing. E need to be replaced by te dash. Remember, the combination E and id has an entry, E produces te dash. That much you remember now. Now let me go back. See, this E is replaced by te dash. This E is replaced by te dash. That's it. The entry for the combination E and id available in the table that need to be replaced by this symbol. LHS will be replaced by RHS. That's all. Right hand side, whatever is available with the production capital E, that we are replacing. That is a step number one. Once if you understand step number one, look at, I need to make a pair. Now who is the top of the stack? The top of the stack is capital T. This is the fellow available on top of the stack. Who is the symbol of or symbol to be considered on the input buffer is the very first symbol in the direction left to right scanning. When I start scanning left to right, one symbol at a time I'm considering. So that ID. Now you need to remember the pair T, ID. Remember, because of different pages, the content is available. If it is whiteboard, I can keep everything beside. Now T, ID. Now let us go back to the table. TID pair we need to remember. Look at the TID pair. T is here, ID is here. What it suggests? TID pair suggests T produces FT dash. So that on the stack, T is to be removed. It should be replaced by FT dash. Remember FT dash. Now let us go there. Look at this T is replaced by FT dash. All the subsequent entries are available that we should not disturb. E dash is retained as such, dollar is retained as such. Only the instance called T is replaced by FT dash. This is what so far now we walked through. Next, I need to make a pair. Always I need to make a pair between top of the stack symbol, left extreme symbol of the input. So left extreme symbol is ID. Now you should remember in your mind the pair capital F, ID. Let us go to the table and refer what is the entry for the FID. It would be FID only, but anyway, in order to make you to understand, I'm going there. Remember in your mind FID pair. With that remembrance, I'm walking to this table. I need to locate F. That F is this person, ID is this person. For this combination, what is the production available? FID. Now this F need to be replaced by ID on the stack. That is why we are referring the parse table. There is no other purpose. Only replacement only we are coming. Now that entry has FID. So that what I am doing, this F is erased and it is replaced by ID. Now again, I need to look at the topmost of the stack. I need to look at the topmost of the input. ID, which is called matching. ID, whenever I am seeing terminal and terminal, the combination terminal and terminal comes, parse table doesn't have this combination. Then cancellation, pop out and this cancel, or instead of cancel, you need to move the symbol, scanning symbol to the next ID, plus. Next, you need to move the symbol to the pointer to the plus. So ID and ID, it is called matched, so that our entry of the stack and buffer would become T dash E dash dollar plus ID star ID dollar. Now to whom I need to look at? I need to look at T dash. I need to look at plus. Now you need to remember the pair combination T dash and plus. This is the pair you need to remember in your mind. We need to look at that table, T dash and plus. Now I am going to that table, T dash and plus. Recollect, this is a combination, T dash and plus. Now what it says, the entry says T dash produces epsilon. What is the meaning? Remove T dash or replace T dash by epsilon. That is the meaning. With that introduction, let us move here. Then because of that epsilon production, what I am doing, this T dash is erased or replaced by epsilon. See, not available. Now who is the top of the stack? After that replacement of the production, E dash is the top of the stack. Next, who is the left hand side of the symbol? Plus. Now I need to remember in my mind the pair E dash and plus. With this remembrance, the pair E dash and plus, I can go and refer the table. Now I am moving to E dash and plus. Look at here, E dash is here, plus is here. For this pair, the entry is E dash produces plus T E dash. What is the meaning is, the moment you see on the top of the stack E dash, that need to be kicked out or popped out. After popping, you need to push this or replace E dash by plus T E dash. You need to replace. Let us go to that position. Now what I am doing, this E dash is, this is what the pair we made, E dash and plus. Now this E dash is replaced by plus T E dash. That is the point we are doing. Now next step, you need to look at, after replacement, you need to look at top of the stack. You need to look at left extreme of the input. This would become plus plus. Just now I said, any moment if you have this pair combination of terminal and terminal, match is happening or cancellation is happening. Remove this, remove this. Then rewrite the remaining TE dash dollar. Rewrite the remaining ID star ID dollar. Is this clear, Manav? D4. Two times every instance we have seen. Is it clear, Ma? D4? From the beginning, we walked through. Okay, Ma. Fine. Thank you. Now, let us proceed further in order to complete this parsing action. We stopped at matching the plus. Now, what is the pair I need to consider? We need to look at this row. Just for your continuity, I'm giving hint. What is a pair I need to consider now for the table reference? Non-terminal and terminal pair, T and ID, fantastic. T and ID I need to consider. Look at, T is my top of the symbol stack, ID is the beginning of the input buffer. I need to consider the pair T and ID. Now I don't go there. It would be naturally TFT dash. So I know that. So that is what. So now, because of this production, T needs to be replaced by FT dash, so that T is replaced by FT dash. The remaining symbol E dash and dollar is retained as such, E dash and dollar. Now let us look into the further steps. Now which is the pair I need to consider? Now you need to look at this line. What is the pair I need to consider? Hint I am giving. F and ID. Excellent. F and ID. Now I need to look at top of the stack. Top of the stack is F. Now I need to look at left extreme symbol of the input buffer. The pair is F and ID. If you look at the table, if you go to the table also, definitely you will be having this entry. Then I need to erase this F. F need to be replaced by this ID. That is what happening here, ID. The remaining all symbol we need to retain as such. T dash, E dash, dollar. Yes, it is retained as such. Now, with that understanding, let us move to the next step. Now we need to look at top of the stack. Top of the stack is ID. We need to look at left extreme symbol of the input buffer. It is ID, ID pair. It is terminal, terminal pair. When it becomes ID, ID, cancellation or popping and removal, that operation is happening. After the removal, this is what the left out information. We are concentrating on this row. When we concentrate, this symbol we need to consider because T dash is the topper of or topmost of the stack. Then who is top of the stack? Star is the top of the stack. So when I consider these two, T dash pair, T dash and star pair, if you look at the table, definitely what would be available is T dash produces star FT dash. Then what I supposed to do? I need to replace this T dash by star FT dash. The remaining information, remaining left out symbols are E dash and dollar, so that I am retaining as such. With that understanding, now let us make a pair. Top of the stack is star, left extreme of the input buffer is star star. So now the pair is star star. Whenever terminal and terminal combination comes, we need to just remove. So that removed. Now let us see the continuation. Continuation is not available here. Let us see. I have missed it. So now I do the remaining. What I supposed to write here? Tell me. Now star and star cancellation I did. Now what should become the entry of that position where I kept my cursor? There are 2-3 steps left out. ID. Yeah, ID plus ID star. Excellent. ID plus ID star. Now with that I am moving. Now here the entry should become capital F T dash E dash dollar. My entry should become like this. Next, if I come here, my entry would be ID dollar. Next, if I come here, FID, F and ID. Already this combination we have seen. Look at this. I now need to go and visit my table. F and ID combination. F and ID combination, I did it. So for that F and ID combination, what is the production? ID. So that I can replace without referring the table. F produce, capital F produces. God, F produces ID. That's all. Capital F produces ID. This is my next step. Now, what is the step available here is same ID plus ID only. Nothing more will get changed. Now I need to write ID plus ID star. Now I need to look at the pair. F is replaced by ID. Remaining T dash and E dash going to be the same. Dollar. Here also ID dollar. Now because of this, it is termed as match ID cancellation. Match ID. Now match ID is there. Now I need to write ID plus ID star. We need to recognize one more ID. Until then, we need to work hard. That is the only solution. T dash, E dash, dollar. Now, the input which is available is dollar. Here. ID dollar. The input which is available is ID dollar. ID matched na? Then ID matched means I need to write here ID. Sorry. We have done. Only T dash, E dash and dollar is available. Fine, fantastic. Now what is the pair I need to look at? Come on guys, help me. Star instead of action column. Star instead of... No ma, star match is already done. See, with the table itself, the table which I have did earlier before the session itself, star is matched. After that, the moment match remains, the input symbol will be collected with a star. So remaining is T, FT dash, E dash, dollar. Here remaining is ID, dollar. Because matched means I need to cancel, throw it away. Then ID, FID. Because of this production FID, I'm replacing F by ID. Then remaining will be contained the same, ID, dollar. Then If I look at this ID and this ID is matches, the moment it matches need to be thrown. Then I need to gather in this collection ID plus ID star ID. Now left out informations are T dash E dash dollar on the stack. On the buffer we have only the dollar. That's all, only two more steps. I'm going to conclude it will successfully match. I'm going right only. Now, what is the pair I need to look at on the table? Tell me. The step where I stopped, after that, what pair I should look at? Because always that pair combination only helps us the parts table reference. Whatever parts table dictates, we are doing. Nothing more we are doing. It's exactly matching. T and dollar. Very good. T and dollar. Now T and dollar, let us make a pair in our mind. Sorry, T dash and dollar. Let us make a pair, the combination T dash and dollar. Let us go to that table and see. T dash is here and dollar is here. Look at the combination. T dash produces epsilon. With that combination, what I supposed to do, I need to replace this T dash by epsilon. Here I need to write the production. Later on I will replace by epsilon. Tentatively I write epsilon in English. T dash produces epsilon. Now what I supposed to do, it is going to become the same. ID plus ID star ID. Now here T dash vanishes, nothing available because it is replaced by epsilon. E dash dollar would be available with my stack. Stack contents are E dash dollar. Input buffer is going to have dollar. Now what is the pair I need to consider in my mind for the table reference? Table only guides me. My brain is also not guiding. You can think there is a lot of, E dash and dollar. I need to make a pair. E dash and dollar. Let us visit the table. Then let us come back here. E dash dollar. Remember, if I forget also, I'll take your help. E dash dollar. Look at the pair. E dash epsilon. It gives E dash epsilon. Let us walk to that position. Then it dictates E dash epsilon. For this pair, it is dictating us to replace E dash by epsilon. So that this input matching symbol would become the same. Nothing we are doing. We are trying to finish the job. ID star ID. Now it is going to become E dash is replaced by epsilon. So that it will become dollar. Stack content is dollar. Then input buffer is dollar. Now dollar comes. It is called stop action. Parsing is stopped. Always you need to worry when this madam is going to stop the session. Like that parsing action, when it will stop is, stack must contain only $1 symbol. Input buffer should contain only $1 symbol. For that combination, parsing action stops. Now stopped. We started with loading $$. Here input string, here starting symbol. We reached here only $$. That is the scenario for starting. This is the scenario for stopping. In between, all the time we will make a pair, top of the stack, left extreme symbol of the input string. For that pair, we will look at the table. What table says, that way we will be replacing the stack content. Then terminal-terminal combination comes. All the terminal-terminal combination is cancellation. That means matching. The matching is happening, we need to cancel. Immediately we need to look at what is after the cancellation, top of the stack. What is left extreme of the input buffer? For that pair, we need to look at the table. What table says we need to do? It is a kind of recursive action. Guys, could you able to understand? Do you have any doubts on this? I'm going to stop the recording, but I will continue your